Bench press, arguably a lot of guys' favorite lift. I still believe in its importance in a solid strength training program, especially for football players, if done correctly. So remember, the whole goal of our benching is to build strength and power, upper body strength and power. It's not to work on your pec development or work on your upper body development. So for your bodybuilders, I wouldn't bench this way. What I'm going to do first is show you a bad setup and a bad set. No, I should like earn an Oscar for that, but that, once again, is how to not do it. So once again, that was an example of how not to do it. Where did I go wrong? It all starts with stability. You know, if you're a science nerd like me, you're always kind of seeing how things work. And last time I checked, they don't launch the space shuttle from a rowboat. No, they launch the space shuttle from a super solid foundation. So it's the same thing in regards to bench pressing. Your bench is only going to be as good as your foundation. You need to make sure you are tight, locked, and stable, and then pressing from that foundation. So first things first, you want to make sure you get your feet pulled back, chest is tall. Get yourself down on that bench, and before I even grab the bar, I'm locked down. There's tension through my quads, tension through my hips, tension through my abs. Everything is locked down. Now, other mistakes. Again, when I'm talking about stability, I want to keep my back in contact with that bench. I don't want to lose my shoulder stability. So a lot of guys will set up in a bench that's too high for them, where they have to protract and reach out to come off the hooks. And a lot of guys, when they press, will focus so hard on pressing the bar away from them that they lose their stability. So you want to get tight, pull out of the rack, and then as you press, think about driving yourself away from the bar, not the bar away from you. And then the last mistake I made, that was supposed to be a warm-up set, and I just threw plates on the bar. I don't care if you think you're a 600-pound bench presser, start with a bar. You know, you want to be able to bench the bar like it weighs 600, and 600 like it weighs a bar. And once you establish those foundational principles, you'll be good to go. Now into my working set. I wanted to show you guys the superset in full effect. I have you guys supersetting your bench press with a horizontal pull-up. So I'm going to show you the full thing. Just one piece of advice in terms of picking your weights, and anytime I have something where I'm prescribing an AMAP, a rep out set, as many as possible, you know, when it comes to getting better in training, last time I checked, unless you're a powerlifter, you're not going to win any awards on how much weight is on the bar. No, you need to check your ego at the door and not turn lifting into a pissing contest. You need to approach it with the mentality that the present day you is constantly defeating the previous day you, and that's how you're going to use training to your advantage. If you just try to start throwing weight on the bar to impress someone else at the gym, you're not really going to be getting the full effect of training.